Hi everyone, this is Brendan here and welcome to my next episode, day 8 of my Let's Clash series. So before we do some upgrades, I'd like to show you guys one attack. So as you can see, for this particular base, there's 300,000 gold available and 293,000 elixir available. So just having level 2 barbarians and level 3 archers. So we're just going to go for it and see how well we can do for this attack itself. Not having any wall breakers is going to have a hard time for my barbarians to pass through that level 5 gold walls. But nevertheless, they went through the walls. Having only just one more spell left for me, a level 1 lightning spell, and I didn't want to use it. So just let my troops do whatever they have to do. Archers taking out the structures really quickly. Level 3 archers, they are pretty strong, pretty awesome. But definitely, I'll try to get them to level 5 or even level 6 as fast as possible so that the damage will increase a lot. And with the total damage being at 35%, we should be able to get to 50% with the gold storage on the top getting destroyed right now. However, my troops are being taken out really quickly by the splash damage dealing defenses such as the mortar and also the wizard tower. So they are going down really quickly, but hopefully we'll be able to get the 50% with the archer shooting away trying to get the storages down, especially the one in the middle over there taking out the elixir storage right now. So once the elixir storage go down, we should be able to get to 50%. So once the elixir storage go down right now, we will get the 50% 1 star. So ending the battle with a 1 star. So now let's proceed on into the upgrades. So the first thing I'd like to show you guys what I did today was that my army camp completed, and then eventually I proceeded on into doing some removal of the obstacles, definitely to get some gems. However, from this particular removal, I got 3 gems, which is not too bad. And then eventually I went to do some more upgrades, and then first thing I upgraded was my barrack. I wanted to unlock more housing space to be able to train more troops in my barracks so that it will be easier for me to train troops when I want to stock troops up in my army camp. So that's something that I want to focus on for today, as my town hall is upgrading to town hall 6 and will be ready in 1 day 9 hours. So I do not need to focus too much on resources. I just have to wait for the time of the town hall to be ready. Then after that, I will have to focus more on the resources, as the walls have already been maxed and I do not have much things to upgrade other than to wait for my builders to be done with their upgrades on the other stuff. And especially for the town hall itself, I'm really looking forward to getting to town hall 6 so that I'll have more upgrades available and definitely be able to upgrade my walls to level 6 walls, the pink wall, pink crystal wall. That would be really nice. So to me, pink crystal wall and gold wall, they look really awesome when they change from gold to pink crystal. So that's something that I really love to look at. Especially the dark crystal, the dark purple crystal, it looks really awesome, especially for like a low town hall level. It looks pretty nice and it looks pretty decent looking, especially when it's like dark in color, this and that. But definitely to proceed on into those like lava walls, level 9, level 10 walls, those are really awesome too. However, it's pretty expensive to upgrade one level 9 wall to a level 10 wall. It costs 3 million per piece of wall. So that's something that I have to work on next time when I proceed into Town Hall 9. So Town Hall 9 would be the hardest Town Hall to technically level up your walls, because it requires 2 levels of leveling up from level 8 to level 10. But if you were to total up the amount of gold needed, it requires only 1 plus 3 million, which is 4 million gold. Whereas for Town Hall 10 to upgrade from level 10 to 11 walls is also a total of 4 million gold. But I would say because of the loot penalty, a Town Hall 10 will be much harder to upgrade the 4 million walls, because it will be much harder to find a decent base to attack. Decent, what I mean by decent is like for example, if we were to find a Town Hall 8 and the Town Hall 8 has 400,000 gold available, the Town Hall 9 will be able to see it as 360,000 gold. However, the Town Hall 10 being 2 Town Hall levels above that Town Hall 8 will only be able to see it at 200,000. For those of you who can't really understand what it means by a loot penalty, this and that, I did make a video, a tutorial of explaining how and what it means by loot penalty. So I'll put a link in the description below. You guys can go and check it out, and also check out my other tutorial guides, which I've already talked about. So yeah, another raid, as you can see, this Town Hall 7 is an exposed Town Hall 7. So as of now, I'm just focusing on elixir because I really need elixir a lot. That is why although this base only had 19,000 gold available, I decided to attack and go for it, because the elixir available was pretty high, so I wanted the elixir more than the gold, because I wanted to do more of my elixir upgrades. I was just preparing for my next upgrades itself, so getting the elixir storage on the right, and then now trying to get a little bit more elixir on that particular storage itself. However, just managed to get some damage out of it. And then now we proceed back to the top. As you can see, the archers they are taking out the town hall itself has just gone down. And then I eventually entered the battle, scoring me 60%, 2 stars. So back to my base, removing one obstacle which did not get me any gems at all. So now doing the upgrade of the gold storage, needing 100,000 elixir. That is why I needed the elixir from that previous raid itself. So upgrading the gold storage will get me more gold capacity so that I could stock up gold for my next town hall level itself. So the next raid, as you can see, I was just going for it because the gold was pretty high and also the elixir was just okay. So now deploying my troops at the bottom in a V-shaped manner, trying to clear out as much of the collectors and the gold mines as possible, as I didn't want to focus on the top and hopefully be able to clear out the whole entire base, as I wanted to take out the splash damage dealing defenses as fast as possible, especially the mortar on the left side over there and also the wizard tower on the bottom. And then eventually the air defense tried to take out some of my minions. So now my barbarians and the archers, they're just tearing through the base with only a level 2 walls. It's pretty easy for my barbarians to break through the walls, so this is the reason why I suggest trying to upgrade your walls fast enough, maybe having them at the same rate, at the same pace as your defenses. However, for me, being this experienced in the game and I know how to farm really fast, I do not need to focus too much on the defenses itself. That's why I'm focusing a lot on the walls, because the walls, they are really hard to upgrade when you reach higher level. That's why I want to upgrade them as fast as possible. So now going back and take a look at my profile itself, I've done 201 attacks for this whole entire season right now. Today, I just did only 6 attack wins, did some losses, so I did maybe around 10 raids of farming because there wasn't too much for me to farm. So yeah, we will proceed on into the next episode, the next day tomorrow, hopefully be able to do more upgrades, more farming, and also more progress in the game, and hopefully be able to reach to Town Hall 6 in just 1.5 more days. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching this episode, and clash on.